Hey guys, thank you so much for tuning in today. First of all, I just want to thank you so much for all your comments. Please keep them coming since it really encourages me to make more of these videos. I also want to help you guys learn as much as you can, so I've actually created a dedicated Facebook page where you can post your work or post any questions you might have for the community to answer. We're all on this XR journey together, so please like and subscribe and join our Facebook page so we can continue to make cool shit together. Anyway, here's your video. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to account for controllers in Aframe. Before we get started on any coding, I want to show you something that will change your life. So up until now, we've been using Chrome, but for this lesson, we're going to be switching to Firefox. And the reason behind that is because Firefox actually has a WebXR API emulator that allows you to use these emulated controllers that lets you interact with the scene that you've created on Aframe. If you don't have Firefox, get it. And when you're done, you want to type in Firefox WebXR Emulator. It's the first link. And then you're just gonna add it to Firefox. This is the code that we use in our tutorial, and we just wanna use it to see how the emulator actually looks. Now we're gonna preview the scene, and then right click, inspect, and then we're gonna click on WebXR. And now you've got this whole new interface that you've probably never seen before. I'm just gonna move this to the right for easier access. So now you can see that this emulator has a lot of different devices here. Let's take a look at them. You've got the Oculus Go, Google Cardboard. Some has a controller, some has two controllers, and others like the Google Cardboard and the Samsung Galaxy S8 doesn't really have a controller. Now, if you look at the Aframe docs, you can see that Aframe has actually accounted for all the different types and configurations of controllers. You have 3 degrees of freedom, and you've got 6 degrees of freedom. Now, what do these actually mean? 3 degrees of freedom means that you can move in 3 different directions. If you look at this diagram, it sort of explains what it means by 3 directions. So really, it's only rotation in the X, Y, and Z axis. 3 degrees of freedom actually represents the direction in which your head can move. You can look right and left around the Y axis, up and down across the X axis, and of course turn left and right around the Z axis. 6 degrees of freedom implies that you can move in 6 directions. So not only can you roll your head around, you can also move linearly in the X, Y, and Z direction. Let's look at this fun little diagram that I found. So again, not only can you move your head around, but you can move forward, backwards, left, right, up, and down. Going back to the documentation, Aframe supports 3 different devices for 3 degrees of freedom. These devices are Daydream for Google, Gear VR for Samsung, and Oculus Go. For 6 degrees of freedom, Aframe supports HTC Vive and Oculus Touch. It's pretty inconvenient having to account for all these different devices, right? Luckily, Aframe has given us 2 solutions that are a little bit more cross-platform. The first one is called Laser Interactions, and the second one is called Superhands. Now, if you go into the documentation and under components, go to laser controls, you can see that they've given you a whole lot of information to work with here. But what we're interested in today is literally all the properties that we can use. You've got which hand to use. So what that's referring to is, you know how before we can see that some devices only have 1 controller, others 2. This is to specify whether this controller that we're instantiating is the right or the left hand. It's also got the model. So that's to do with if the model is the default hand controller when it's loaded. And of course, there's the default model color. Okay, so that's pretty easy. I'm gonna start by pasting this line of code in. And then instead of left, I wanna use the right hand. And let's see what happens when we actually run this. Can't see anything yet because you have to go to the inspect tool and open up WebXR, and instead of HTC Vive, because this is the left hand, I want to go for the Oculus Quest. Now you can't see it yet because you have to click this VR bottom, and because I've used this before, it looks pretty much like what we expect. When you first open this tool, you're going to get something like this,
because by default stereo effect is on, all you have to do is toggle it off and you get something like this. What you can do is you can actually move this around now, like this. Alright, and since the Oculus Quest has 6 degrees of freedom, you can actually move it right, left, up, down, side to side. Just so we can prove a point, I'm going to show you what happens when we switch to the Oculus Go, which we know is a 3 degrees of freedom device. So when you click on it, you can actually only rotate this. Switch it back to the good old Oculus Quest. Notice how the laser doesn't actually go through the object. So what does that mean? I'm gonna take a wild guess and say that you can actually select things. Which makes sense, right? Because essentially that's what a controller is for. Let's test out this theory. We wanna make it so when this box is clicked, it starts to spin around. I'm gonna add an animation component as usual, and don't forget to add the Aframe animation component script at the top or it won't work. Property, rotation, and I want it to go from 000 to 360, 360, 0. I want it to take 2000 milliseconds and start event is on click. Okay, make sure that there's no syntax errors. I really hope this works because I've had so many syntax errors today. It is not my day. Hey, there we go. So when I squeeze this button, the emulator controller turns blue and then it rotates in two directions as we expected. Now let's look at the hand controls component. Of course, starting with the documentation. So again, if you go under components and then look under hand controls, you can see what properties are available. So again, exactly the same as the laser pointers, you've got the color of the hand material. So before it was the hardware device, and then you've got the hand itself, which one is it? Is it the right or the left one? And the hand model style. So Aframe comes with a few different versions. There's the low polygon and the high polygon, or the cartoon hand. So it's just, you know, just play around with it. We won't go over it today, but basically it just affects what the hand looks like. So default is low poly. So let's just go with that. Let's copy this code. Okay, so I've actually taken out the laser controls that we had before. Instead of left hand, we're gonna go right. And right. And here we've actually changed the color of the hand, which is totally fine. Let's try to run it. Okay, again, you can't see anything yet. You have to go to WebXR and click the VR button. This is what we got so far, but that's not enough for this lesson. We're gonna add a component called Super Hands. Super Hands lets you do way more than just point and click at a component. It lets you grab, stretch, drag, drop, all sorts of things. Let's go to the Super Hands documentation and chuck in the script. Okay, so if you haven't done it yet, basically copy this line of code. I've actually already done it in my glitch instance. And now we can add Super Hands. And just like that, Super Hands is installed. But there's one thing missing. Before, when we were using the laser controls, we knew what object that we were clicking because the laser essentially intersected with the object. But this time with Super Hands, it doesn't quite work that way. We need the hand model to be able to touch one of the objects and essentially collide with it, right? And on top of that, we need to find out if this collision has happened. Super Hands library actually already comes with a solution for this. And this solution is called a sphere collider. All you need to do is install the component. And then let it know what object to look out for. And this time is just in a box. And then the only thing left to do is add exactly how we want our hands to interact with the object. So here I'm gonna use grabbable. And just to remind you, you've got all these reaction components here. Super Hands has a dash in between. Yes, look out for syntax errors. I often type without really thinking, and it's really such a waste of time. But anyway, this should work now. So if I inspect this element, and then I go to WebXR, and I'm just gonna do a simple translate. Oh, oops, gotta turn that VR symbol on. So I'm just gonna take the hand all the way down here. And so if I move it, it should kind of disappear into the box, basically showing that the box is touching the hand. Then I'm gonna squeeze the button and that should grab the box. So you can see the hand kind of clenches into a fist a little bit. And then you just move the box around. Look at that, guys. So now it's as if the hand is dragging the box around. Okay, so hopefully you've learned something today. Don't make the same mistakes as I did, because it took me just so long to figure out. And yeah, have a good day. I'll see you next time.
Hey guys, just a quick update. I've been super busy pivoting my business to focus more on AR and VR. There's going to be a lot of new stuff coming, so please hit subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell so you can stay updated. Building the XR community on this channel really means a lot to me and brings me a lot of joy. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.